In the final episode of our special series this week on food waste, we look at some innovative solutions being developed to deal with the growing problem of spoiled and surplus food in this country. Special correspondent Allison Aubrey visited a state where dairy farmers are using it to power their farms and more.
It's burger night at Barstow's Dairy and Bakery at Longview Farm in Hadley, Massachusetts, and the Pioneer Valley String Band has drawn a crowd. As advertised, the burgers are born and raised here. But the cows on this farm produce more than just meat.
Our cows are producing about 100 pounds of cow manure per cow per day, and we're treating it through this system and getting electricity. It's renewable energy that's coming right here from the farm.
The system that seventh generation farmer Denise Barstow is talking about is an anaerobic digester. Those green towers are part of it. She's one of a handful of dairy farmers in Massachusetts using the technology. Just down the road, dairy farmer Peter Melnick is using it too.
We are taking food waste from all over the greater Boston area and our very own cow manure. We mix them together in the digester vessel and make electricity.
This land has been in Melnick's family for four generations, but times are tough for dairy farmers, so Melnick has diversified. His land is now part farm and part renewable energy plant. The process starts here.
This is the manure pit, as we like to call it.
But he needs more than manure. The trick to making this waste-to-energy system profitable is volume. And Melnick has found an abundant source. Millions of pounds each year of surplus and spoiled food that would otherwise be destined for a landfill now arrives at his farm in trucks like this. The food scraps are ground up into a liquid slurry that gets pumped into this pit. The more you add, the more electricity you can make. The waste comes from all over. There's unsold produce from Whole Foods, scraps and whey from a Cabot butter plant, and spent grain from a local brewery.
Inside the digester, it's about almost a million gallon tank. It's heated to 105 degrees. And inside there are tiny microbes.
Microbes from these cows' digestive tracts and the rotting food produce methane, which is usually released into the atmosphere, playing a role in climate change. But here, when the gas is captured, it's stored in these big black bubbles, and Melnick can actually generate power from it.
We produce a megawatt of electricity every hour.
How much is that?
A megawatt is enough to power the digester and the dairy farm, our houses and outbuildings at here, and we still have 90% of our electricity to be able to put back on the grid.
And the other 90%? It powers some of the businesses that send their waste to the digesters. It also powers two local towns. They're able to purchase the electricity at a 10 to 15% discount.
So what is it that you get from this? How does this help your bottom line?
We are getting about $100,000 a year in savings.
The digesters are built and run by a company called Vanguard Renewables. The company pays farmers a fee for the use of their land and gives them free electricity to power their farms and houses. In addition to the economic boost, Melnick says he likes the environmental benefits.
I don't need an app or a environmental calculator to tell me that this thing just makes sense. Having such a closed loop system, it's really been neat to see the connection between all the food companies.
One player in this loop is Whole Foods. 17 of their stores participate. They ship 50 to 100 tons of food waste every week to their digesters. At the stores, they grind up food they can't sell or donate and then truck it to Melnick's farm. Whole Foods' Karen Franchik explains.
Anything that ends up going to landfill or incineration costs us more money. That is the most expensive way to get rid of waste in our stores.
So sending the waste to the anaerobic digester is cheaper and can help reduce the ecological footprint. Up to 10% of all greenhouse gas emissions are linked to food waste. And in 2014, Massachusetts passed a law to ban food companies from sending their waste to landfills. It applies to all businesses that generate over a ton of food waste a week. So far, four other states in the U.S. have passed similar bans.
Each part of the food waste stream.
John Meyerchek is president of the Center for Ecotechnology, a nonprofit that helps businesses in Massachusetts save energy and reduce waste.
To transport food waste super long distances is very expensive and also wasteful. So the idea was to try to put dots in the map all across the state, close to where the waste is produced so that it could be used to produce energy. And the state did this by incentivizing the development of these digesters.
Those dots are now sprinkled across the state, and incentives came in the form of grants given to the companies to build the digesters. John Hanselman is Vanguard's CEO. He says he's inspired by what's happened in Europe, where there are over 17,000 digesters and government policies to promote renewable energy.
So we saw what was happening in Europe, where anaerobic digestion was extremely widespread. Across the United States, we don't have that incentive program. We don't have the federal energy policy or any federal benefits for anaerobic digestion. I think we are at the cusp. We are at the early days. We've finally got the economics to work.
Hanselman says after 6 years in the making, he expects to make a profit this year. And he's optimistic about the growth. This waste-to-energy approach is new in the U.S., and the extent to which it can take off may depend on how much states or the federal government are willing to incentivize it. In Massachusetts, it took two new laws, a food waste ban and a renewable energy law, plus grants to make it happen. Farmer Denise Barstow is glad it's all worked out.
You can't just work really hard anymore and make it in the dairy industry. You have to work smarter, not just harder. And part of that is diversifying in a way that is better for the land, better for the animals, and better for the next generation.
For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Allison Aubrey of NPR News in Hadley, Massachusetts.
And you can see all of our stories on the topic of food waste on our homepage. That's pbs.org/newshour.